Lair can be incredibly fun, but it is also difficult thanks to the new update. The ghost is now smarter and has better mechanics.
How will I possibly survive the ghost then, High Blaster? I'm just a noob and I cannot even go into the house without being scared.
Shut up. I am here to help you. In this guide I will provide you with all the things I have learned from playing this game, and how you can be the master in this game, and can bully the ghost too. This is a long video as I will be explaining everything, so sit back, grab some popcorn and relax. Let's start off with the basics. What is Blair? It is a game inspired by Phasmophobia in which you have to find the ghost type by searching for three unique evidences. Each ghost type has its own set of three evidence. If your sanity goes low, the ghost will start hunting and can kill you. You have to find the ghost type and get out alive. In a game where equipments play a big role, it's necessary to understand everything about them. These equipments will help you find the ghost type. The first one is thermometer, which costs $30 in the shop. By using thermometer you can find the ghost room and also if the ghost exhibits freezing temperature or not. Next, it's EMF reader. The EMF reader costs $45 in the shop and can read EMF, allowing players to guess the ghost's activities based on the reader's EMF level. There are several stages or levels to the EMF. Level 1 means it's on and there is no activity. Level 2 and 3 indicate that the ghost is nearby or has interacted with an item nearby. Level 4 is pretty much the same. Level 5 indicates that the ghost exhibits an evidence which you can put in your journal. The sound is different for level 2 and level 5. Keep the sound in mind and don't get confused. Next is the spirit box, which costs $50 in the shop. Spirit box is used to find out a ghost evidence. You have to turn it on and ask the ghost several questions in which the ghost will answer. Keep in mind, the ghost will not answer every time as the evidence is not guaranteed every time. There is a trick for the spirit box. You can turn it on and off repeatedly, as there is a small chance that the ghost will answer without even being asked a question. Next is ghost writing book, which costs $40. You just place the book in the ghost room, and the ghost will write in it. That's it. It's just a book, what else do you expect? Next is video camera, which costs $50. Video cameras are used to find ghost orbs. Just place the camera in the ghost room and go back to the van and use the computer to see if there are ghost orbs or not. I recommend waiting for around 30 seconds, and also asking your friends, if you have any, to check with you as it can make the process sometimes faster. Next is UV light, which costs $35. UV lights are used to find fingerprints. Check at the doors which were opened by the ghost, and you may find a fingerprint. Next is flashlight. There are two different types of flashlights. The normal one and the strong one. The normal one is free, and the strong one costs $50 each. Flashlights are your best friend as it provides light source to the player. Lighter is also a type of light source equipment, but its main objective is to light up candles, which can be crossed off if there is an objective for it. Then we got support equipment. Let's talk about the kits. Kits play a crucial role, and I have already explained every kit in one of my videos earlier. In this video, I won't be wasting your time and will tell you directly to either use All-Seeing Kit, Brave Kit or the Ghost Whisper Kit, as those are the best. Apart from these three, every other kit is bad. So now you know about the equipments, and you have selected your kit depending on your playstyle. Congratulations. Now the real game starts. Once you step into the house, your death clock starts ticking. You now share the same roof temporarily with an entity which can send you to hell. But worry not, even after the update, this ghost suffers from memory issues and has myopia. Let's talk about your strategy. Your planning should start before you even start the game. If you are playing with your friends, talk to them and equally distribute the equipments among yourselves, which will save your time. I have talked about the sweep method in my earlier videos. But still I will quickly explain what that means. Suppose you are playing in Roadhouse with three other friends. You ask them to take different corners of the house as shown in the photo. The one who finds the ghost room will alert the team, and then you guys can start preparing for step 2. Step 2 is going to the ghost room and trying to find the evidence as quickly as possible. The ghost isn't a kid who will give you another chance. Now there are two ways after step 2. First one is you got the evidence, you got the ghost type, and you made it out alive. Congratulations, you won. But the other outcome is the ghost started hunting. Now the real trouble started. You are a goat waiting to be butchered, and you have no idea what to do. Luckily, there are closets in which you can hide in, but beware if the ghost sees you going in the closet, then it will open the closet and will kill you. Well, if no closets, then what to do? There are hiding places where you can hide, and the ghost will not find you. One hiding spot which is considered a bug by the developers is this spot. They are saying they will fix it in the future updates, so now's your chance to use it and gain some quick levels. I wouldn't be wasting time telling you guys every spot in every map, as this video isn't about the hiding spots. It's about you surviving. Well, hiding and surviving are related, but you get the idea. Always keep the closets open so that you don't waste time during the hunt. Time efficiency is very important in this game, as you will be losing your sanity a lot. For new players who are scared of this game, I recommend changing the music to Crab Rave song in the lobby to cool it off between the games. Playing solo can be a bit scary for the new players, that's why I always find a team, as it will not scare you that much. If you are unable to find a team, I recommend joining the official Discord server of the game and asking there. Just don't say Yuwu, as it makes the people go monkey mode. Ghost traits are a thing now, and as I am making this video, two ghosts, Banshee and Poltergeist, got their traits. Once every trait is introduced, I will make a video on it, as it will surely change many people's playstyle. Ouija board is a great tool to use in big maps, as in maps like Orphanage and School, you will be wasting a lot of time trying to find the ghost room. I don't recommend using Ouija board in small maps, but using it in big maps is a good idea. Know the name of every room, and you will face no problem with the Ouija board. Ouija board only has a chance of 50% to spawn. Keep in mind, these tips and the survival guide that I am providing is only for players who are starting the game and need a boost. Once you start playing the game, you will face no troubles, and will also find new tips that you can share to the new players. The beauty of this game is that it keeps evolving, and everyone loves that. Thank you guys for watching. If you liked the video, then do leave a like, as this video took me a long time. If you want tips and tricks and more videos on this game, then do check out my channel. Subscribing is your choice, you can do it if you want to.